Bred for its beauty, fast growth, and tolerance for cold, the aquarium strain of Caulerpa taxifolia, nicknamed killer algae, has wreaked havoc on the Mediterranean Sea since 1984. Caulerpa taxifolia is native to tropical waters in the Caribbean, the Indo-Pacific, and the Red Sea. Caulerpa species are commonly used to decorate saltwater aquariums. In 1980, a cold-resistant strain of Caulerpa taxifolia was discovered at an aquarium in Germany. The hybrid was then shared with several other marine institutions, including the Oceanographic Museum in Monaco. At some point, whether intentionally or accidentally, the hybrid was released into the sea next to the museum. In 1984, French divers noticed a beautiful emerald green algae patch growing on the seafloor, adjacent to the museum. The patch rapidly spread throughout the Mediterranean, forming dense mats and overwhelming native species and habitats. In addition to choking out native species, the invasion has harmed tourism, recreational diving, and commercial fishing. One of the most alarming aspects of Caulerpa taxifolia's invasion is how easily it spreads. Even the tiniest fragment, often broken off by fishing gear, boat anchors, or anchor lines, can establish a new patch. The aquarium strain is genetically different from the native, possessing a dangerous combination of traits. It can tolerate cooler water, grow at a rapid rate, and can thrive at greater depths than the native species. All these factors make eradication difficult. Sadly, early eradication was not attempted in the Mediterranean, and the infestation is now considered beyond control. The aquarium strain can colonize various substrates, from sand, mud, and rocks in calm to moderately exposed habitats. It can even inhabit depths greater than 150 feet. Adding to the problem, the aquarium strain is able to thrive in heavily polluted waters. Each individual alga consists essentially of one cell with multiple nuclei. It grows upright and is secured to the ground with fine hairs called rhizoids. It can grow up to 3 inches per week and reportedly to 10 feet tall. Caulerpa can even survive out of water for multiple days in moist conditions. Outside of Caulerpa taxifolia's native tropical range, there is no known marine life that eats the species in any significant quantities. The algae possess toxic compounds that protect them from grazers. The few fish which are able to eat the algae, such as Mediterranean bream, accumulate toxins in their bodies, making them unsuitable for human consumption. In native waters, many herbivores have immunity to the toxic compounds within Caulerpa, and their grazing keeps the algae from spreading excessively. In 2000, Caulerpa taxifolia was found in 2 coastal water bodies in Southern California and has since been eradicated due to rapid action. The species has also been found in cooler water around Australia. However, Caulerpa taxifolia isn't the only problem. There are other Caulerpa species that have become invasive threats in various areas of the world. Due to their invasive nature, the sale of various Caulerpa species has been banned in many countries to prevent further introductions. For more marine facts, click the subscribe button.